This is the first time for me to take the train to Oslo. On our way to the train, we are going to buy some food and then we'll see what happens on the train. On the way to Oslo, we took the day train, which means that there were no place to sleep. The train took us 6 hours precisely. To be honest, I didn't do much. I had a lot of headache. I tried to watch Siri, but then I fell asleep. The view was so pretty. I love the view, but the downside with this was that we only sat. I was so tired after that. We arrived to Oslo around 10 p.m. I wasn't home until 11 or 12. It was a long trip, but it was worth it. We went to Zara to shop there because we don't have Zara here in Trondheim. We did find some pieces and it was pretty great. They had this self-checkout. After we went for shopping, we walked around the city and tried to explore my hometown. I really miss Oslo. I never realized how much I miss this place until I was there. It was so warm outside, so we bought ourselves some smoothie. This is what I have been craving. Later in the evening, we did celebrate my father-in-law's birthday, but I didn't capture anything from that night because I just want to be present. Before we were traveling up again, we decided to gather together and eat dinner outside on my brother-in-law's rooftop. He had a very pretty rooftop and I wish I also had one of those. So we eat there and we enjoy the night together, talk and had some great time together. I know I haven't been vlogging a lot, but I am going home today. I am currently on the train home. I have my own room. I'm going to give you guys a tour, but I feel so bad that I didn't record a lot when I was in Oslo. On our way home, we have this coupe with bed. Even though we had a bed, I couldn't sleep that good at night. So I ended up getting sick the day after because I didn't get a lot of sleep and I was in the sun a lot. I think I got sick from the sun.
I just came back home from Oslo, but I realized that I didn't record a lot today. I feel so tired, I feel so dizzy and my head hurts. I don't know what the reason is. I think that is because I have been in the sun with preparing my body that I am going to be in the sun. I was supposed to work today. I went to work and then I got back again. My brain couldn't cooperate with me and I just want to lay down and sleep.
It's the middle of the day and then I went back to bed. I woke up, I ate breakfast, drank coffee and then I went back to bed again because since I came home yesterday I felt very bad. Got headache, I still have a headache and I get dizzy when I wake up. I'm just laying in bed trying not to be a lot on screen. I will try to get out of bed later today, go for a walk, trying to be better.
Husband shower first because he needs to go to work before me. I start at 11. It's only 7.
Just got out from the shower. I felt so bad yesterday. I felt sick in some way, so I took a day off from work. I'm fine now. I decided to set up a new bullet journal because I don't want to have a flashback from when I went to college or university. I have a lot of schoolwork to do and that stressed me a lot. So I decided, since I have graduated, I want to start a fresh start. Bullet journal for me is like me documenting my life besides vlogging. Just finished my setup and now I can use this, take this with me when I travel next, because I have a lot of books here and I just want to think of one from time to time. 2 hours until I need to be at work. I should also edit, but I feel so exhausted, so I will wait a little bit. I know I promise you guys a video twice a week, but I don't think I will do that this week because I am so tired and I don't want to burn myself out. I just got ready to work. I like to have my bottle with me to work. This is 1,000 milliliter, a liter. I have drink 1.5 today, so I will have to go to the bathroom often today.